if there's something that we've wanted to see removed from phones since day one, is the notch, the punch hole, or whatever you want to call it. And apparently Samsung has got a solution for that coming soon, I guess. Because yes, it looks like Samsung is bringing a ton of new technologies, but apparently they won't come cheap. According to a new report, Apple Silicon is just getting started, as the following chips are going to be even more advanced than this one's. And we get even more details on everything the Samsung Galaxy S21 lineup is going to do. I'm Jaime Rivera, and listen, as COVID-19 cases continue to spike, it's never too late to just remind everybody again, let's fight this pandemic, let's wear a mask. This is Pocketnow Daily. Let's begin today off with deals, and we've got a good list of products that you should definitely consider and that are relatively new. The latest M1 MacBook Air, which is being used to edit this video, is $50 off. That leaves the 8 gigs of RAM, 512 gigs of solid state drive variant for $1,200. If you're going for a desktop, the new Mac Mini is $29 off, leaving the entry-level variant for $670. The latest 12.9-inch iPad Pro is available for $150 off. That leaves it at $1,499 shipped for 1 terabyte of storage. The brand new iPad Air is also $40 off, leaving the entry-level variant for $559. We've got more deals on Bose earbuds, LG monitors, Hisense TVs, and more in the description. Now let's talk about OnePlus's. The company has definitely taken a lot of the spotlight this year, but it has a lot to do with the amount of products that they've launched. A few weeks ago, OnePlus unveiled two new budget smartphones, the Nord N10 5G and the Nord N100. We'll be focusing on the N100 for this segment because this is supposed to be a cheaper and watered down one out of the pair, but it looks like there was some hidden premium features here. So to recap, it packs a punch hole HD Plus display, a Qualcomm Snapdragon 460 SoC, a 5000 mAh battery, and the triple camera array with 12 megapixels in the main sensor. And yeah, all of this for around $237. So remember that price tag because, well, now that it's out, the guys over at Android Authority just discovered that this N100 actually packs a 90 hertz refresh rate display. OnePlus didn't specify on this, so everyone just assumed it was regular 60 hertz. And again, keep in mind, for the, what, over $200 price tag? That's crazy. So yeah, if you get this phone, make sure to switch those 90 hertz on, as I'm sure that 5000 milliamp hour battery is going to be able to handle it without a problem. If you have been watching us for a bit, you'll know the story of how my iPhone 11 Pro was one of those smartphones that got the green tint issues on the display that eventually got the display to die. And well, apparently that's the case with certain iPhone 12 models. Last weekend, some users started reporting issues with the 12 mini's lock screen sensitivity, and the 12 Pro users were having problems with the messages application, but the most notable problem were display issues. Apparently, some users were getting a green tint on the screen and some flickering, but it looks like Apple noticed. The guys over at Mac Rumors recovered an internal document where Cupertino addresses the issue, saying that they are aware of the customer reports related to the problem and they're actively investigating, telling technicians to avoid servicing these types of issues because there is no real fix at the moment, but they should advise customers to update their phones. Now remember, back in the case of the 11 Pro, Apple fixed it with iOS 13.6.1, so let's see if we get a fix. Thing is, my problem was not solved with a software update. It wasn't even fixed with replacing the display. They had to replace the whole phone. So it might be bigger than that. We'll keep you posted. Now let's keep talking about Apple now in a positive tone, mainly because of Apple Silicon, because I mean, all of us here have to admit, we're still in disbelief, very close to a shock over everything we've discovered these chips to be able to do. Well, we know that the A14 Bionic was the first chip in the market to bring a 5-nanometer process thanks to TSMC, but it looks like they're already pushing smaller nodes. According to a TrendForce research note, Apple plans to use TSMC's next generation 5-nanometer plus process on the A15 chip that will come in 2021 iPhones. TSMC website also says that this 5-nanometer plus process refers switched to an N5P, which is a performance-enhanced version of their current 5-nanometer process, which will deliver additional power efficiency and performance improvements. The report even goes further ahead to 2022, where they believe that the A16 will be a 4-nanometer process, which paves the way to even more performance improvements, power efficiency, and density improvements. This also hints that we might get those improvements on Apple silicon chips. I mean, come on, that should be the case. Maybe with the M1X or M2 or whatever they're gonna be called. The thing is, guys, with the M1 MacBook Air, without a fan, mopping the floor with pretty much every single Intel Mac we've compared it to in the studio, this being Gen 1, can you imagine Generation 2? Because here's the thing, we have never, ever, and you can see our reviews, recommended a first generation Apple product. But this would be the first. Totally. Sure, go for it. I think that that would be the review. Fine. And I know, we're still a segment away from the hottest news, but here's the thing. We've got so much of Samsung that is hot to cover that we just decided to split them in two segments because why not? First off, Ice Universe just went on a tweeting spree giving us a ton of new information on the upcoming Galaxy S line. He started off by posting a new CAD render of the S21 Ultra, which shows us the new chin and side bezels, which let's just say you won't be able to tell a difference if compared to the S20 Ultra. However, he does say that this will be the narrowest chin in a mobile phone in history, which is something Samsung has been perfecting over the years. Other than that, the CAD render showed the USB-C port as well as the display's footprint. But then moving from that, he also posted some case molds where you can see the camera module of the S21 and S21 Plus. Sadly, you can only see the display side from the other two. Finally, he also said that the S21 Ultra screen will refresh multiple records. But I'm not exactly sure if that means we'll be getting something like ProMotion or if it will be just the record-breaking display, I guess? Whatever the case may be, I do have to admit, I am already very excited for whatever that S21 Ultra or S21 is gonna be. But finally, the second segment of the hottest news today continue being about Samsung, particularly with the innovations that we are getting from this company in 2021, which are actually quite interesting. Last month, there was some rumors roaming around that claimed that Samsung would be introducing their first under-the-display camera with the Z Fold 3. Well, now there's a new ET news report that backs the rumors. According to an industry insider, Samsung Display has developed a new display that will support the UDC. Apparently, they made the gap between pixels wider to allow light to pass through, and this will only be a thing in the selfie camera area. The rest of the display will be the same. That, along with some special algorithms, will correct images as light is obviously refracted by the OLED display to allow the camera to work. This camera module will be made by LSI, and apparently the technology won't be ready by the spring or early in the year, which is when we get the S line and the Z Flip. So we will be reportedly getting it on the Z Fold 3 in the third quarter of the year because all of the rumors point to the Galaxy Note line disappearing. A new Ice Universe tweet also sort of backs the claims that the Z Fold 3 will bring a lot of innovative technologies, including this under-display camera and the S Pen along with a second type of UTG. Anyways, let us know in the comments down below if this would lure you to consider a Z Fold 3 or what would be, because honestly, I believe that the biggest problem is people concerned about durability. You pay so much money, is this product really going to last? And they actually have from the testing we've done. But leave us a comment down below. We'd love to know your opinion. Friends, again, if you want to get the news earlier, follow us on Pocketnow.com and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. Also, follow us on social medias. Our extended coverage happens on Instagram. And follow me on my personal handles to see me remind you to wear a mask. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I'm Jaime Rivera. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you tomorrow.